Springtime in Kentucky is truly unique. The memory of the light and colors of spring said hope and rebirth to philanthropist Myra Tobin. She challenged British artist John Reyntiens to capture that beauty. He responded by pushing at the definition and techniques of art glass. The use of nature, trees, and branches to inform the glass makes it an original glass expression of spring.
I spent a lot of time working in ecclesiastical stained glass with my father. My father is pretty well known for stained glass, especially the work he made with Piper in places such as Coventry Cathedral. So he sort of, when you get known for a certain area, that you sort of you end up continuing that kind of artwork. And so I kind of took on his career about 15 years ago.
It is quite difficult having someone who's quite famous, who's your father, doing what you do. It's you sort of have to kind of get yourself to a point where you feel like you're making your own market and you're getting somewhere and you're no longer the son of Patrick. Not that there's any rivalry between the two of us. He said, "That's the best thing I've ever seen you design. That's like no one else's work. I think that looks fantastic." And coming from a person who doesn't really say anything to me about my artwork, I was really touched, and I found it quite emotional. And I thought, he's never really said that to me before. So that was a really nice moment in my heart. And I told him how touched I was, and he wasn't that interested. He sort of said, "Don't worry about that."
When my mum died, and we all went to the chapel. There's the thing about being in a hospital, especially if it's serious. You need everything to make you feel more at home or not more at home. Alleviate your experience you're going through.
It just gives you an uplift when you see art. You want to feel like you're a human being, not just a patient. You want to feel human. And I think art is very good at making you feel less vulnerable about the experience, and certainly my mother felt that. She was an artist and she loved the art, and on occasions she was very down about her situation, and art just helps lift one's spirit. The donor, Myra Lee Tobin. From the outset, she was a very strong influence on, I think, everybody regarding this project. She's a very, very lovely woman, and I've enjoyed her company a great deal. She's like a bullet in her ability to sort of go through information. There's no pause with Myra. You show her something, "I don't like that. That's the wrong colour." The brief for this competition was Springtime in Kentucky. It was a brief that Myra Lee Tobin set, and it sounds really simple to do something about springtime, but I found it's you always go through this period where, when designing something, that you have to, it's the blank piece of paper syndrome. It's terrifying. If you're an artist and you start with a blank piece of paper, what do you do with it? you know, you paint some leaves or you paint some branches, and suddenly I'm working from this perspective that everything I did, it was like representational of springtime. So I was doing trees and branches, and after about 7 or 8 days, I found the entire thing just really, it wasn't doing anything for me. It wasn't until I forgot about using representational stuff and I started working with, I went for the sort of impressionistic approach, and I sort of thought about Monet and also my mother. My mother's a painter, and I thought about some of the things that she had done with cherry blossom and that sort of white, strong white influence. So I started thinking about, let's think about springtime as sort of as you would if you were sort of in a car, so everything's slightly, you can't make out what's going on. And actually, then suddenly everything became very exciting, and it no longer became a chore, but it became a pleasure. A brush is fantastic in the right hands, but then I'm trying to create something that's kind of organic. And so I sort of went out into the wood, and I came out back with some branches. The leaves create such a beautiful sort of mark on the glass that far more exciting than anything I can do with a paintbrush. So that was really exciting. We went from sort of man-made things to nature, and I thought that was quite appropriate because our hospital is full of machines, and I just wanted to get back to a more organic way of doing it. It's nice to do something modern in these sort of spiritual places. I think that the medieval way of doing things was, it was modern art, and it's a continuation. We don't have to carry on producing angels like the Victorians did. We change and we carry on going forward, and I think that's what's very exciting about this UK project, chapel project, is that we're able to do something that's completely modern, but also I'm hoping is also very spiritualist in its whole feeling, so it can relate to different denominations of religious people. And I think I would like to believe that people who had no religious belief could go there and get something from it.